Hi friends, welcome to Wafa Studies. This is part 26 of Azure Data Factory video series. In this video, we are going to discuss about delete activity in Azure Data Factory. So the main agenda is to discuss about delete activity, practically see the implementation of it and how to monitor this delete activity. So why you use this delete activity in ADF, that is Azure Data Factory? So normally if you want to delete any file or folders from any storage, it might be on-premises storage or it might be cloud storage. So in those cases, you will use this delete activity to perform the deletion or archival operations. Okay, so you need to remember one thing: this deletion operation, whatever you perform using this activity, it cannot be restored back. So once you delete any file or folder, then that's it, it is permanently deleted. So be more careful when you are using this particular activity. So let's look at practical implementation of it. Let me open my Azure Data Factory. So this is my Azure Data Factory. So here what I will do, I will create a new pipeline and I will run the this pipeline using the delete activity. So let's say this is delete pipeline. Okay, this is my pipeline name, let's assume. So delete activity will be available something under general. Okay, under general category, there is this delete activity. You just drag and drop onto canvas. Okay, so this is the delete activity. So it has the four sections: general, source, logging settings, user properties. Okay, so general section, you can give the name and the description, and the timeout is here it is 7.00 hours, 00 minutes, 00 seconds. That means 7 days of timeout. So that means this activity can run up to all the way 7 days. If still that didn't completed, then it is going to be failed automatically or it is going to be terminated. Okay, so that is what the timeout. Retry means once if the activity get failed, if you want to retry it once again, then that count. So how many times you want to retry, and retry interval, it's again that interval between the every read time. So every 30 minutes you can start new retry. So that's how you can define. Okay, then coming to source, here you need to provide the source data set under which you want to delete, perform the delete operation of any file or data. Okay, so let's assume what I want to do is, so inside this is actually storage demo. Mahir is one of the my storage account. Inside that I have a ADF demo container. So inside this container I have an output folder. So I want to delete all these files, abcd and data.txt files, from this particular folder. So then what I can do is, simply I can create a data set for that one, which will point to this particular location. So again, what is data set and how to create the data set and linked services, everything we have discussed in my past videos, so please watch them. For example, in this part 6th video, right, we have discussed that linked services and data sets. So search like Wafa Studies in the YouTube and it will open my channel. Then go to play series of Data Factory and you can find the all the videos there. So let's go to our Data Factory. So let's create a new data set. Okay, so the data set is going to be blob storage type. Click on continue. Okay, so this is output folder, right? Output folder data set. So let's give name like this. So linked service, I have already created a linked service for that particular storage account. Linked service is nothing but like a connection string for the storage account. So I'm just selecting that. Then I need to select this location, which container. So this is the container and the folder. So output is the folder. So click OK. Then click OK. So once you do that, you are good with the data set. Then what is recursively? So recursively means, for example, we are pointing this particular data set to output folder, right? Once you click this recursively checkbox enable, then what it will do is, inside this output folder, whatever the files or subfolders or subfiles it has, everything it will be deleted. I mean, all the things it will be deleted automatically. So no file will be available for you. Recursively, it will loop into all the subfolders and all the files and it will delete everything. So that is what recursively meaning is. Then file path type. So file path type. So here is file path from data set. That means inside the data set, whatever the path you have given, so that path. So I have given the inside the data set path is output folder, right? So what this will do, inside the output folder, all the files recursively it will delete. Or what you can do, you can select this wildcard file path. Then what you can do, for example, inside the output folder, recursively I want to delete, but I want to delete only .txt files. then what it will do, it will delete all the txt files inside that particular output folder, and also if there is any txt file inside the subfolders, everything it will delete. Okay, if you uncheck the recursively button, then what it will do, it will delete only these two txt files. If I have any subfolders and inside that subfolders if I have any text files, it will not delete them. Okay, so let it be recursively and let it be star.txt, so that I want to delete all the txt files. Okay, so number of concurrent connections means number of connections, parallel connections you want to make with the source to perform this activity. Okay, so let it be default. I don't want to do anything that. So logging settings, for example, if you want to log the data, what is the file which deleted and what is the file name and file type and everything, if you want to log this kind of information, you can make use of this enable logging setting here. So once you check it, it will ask you to provide the connection linked service details where you want to create this log file. So let's assume I want to create again in the storage demo here. Okay, so inside this storage account I want to create the log file also once this activity completes. So let me give select this. Okay, let me select this ADF demo container, click OK. So inside this container I want the log file to be generated once this activity runs successful. Okay, I have selected everything. Then user properties, as discussed in the previous videos, I think in copy, right, in copy data 24th video, in this video we have discussed about user properties. So user properties are nothing but some properties with few predefined values for your better understanding when you are viewing the activity run inside the monitor tab. Okay, so please watch this video if you are not clear. Or let me do one thing, let me create one thing. Okay, let's say this is, let's say files deleted. Okay, so let's say value like all txt files in output folder of ADF demo container. Okay, so let's say I gave this string here. So this is like a normal value which says me, okay, all the txt files inside the output folder of ADF demo container got deleted. That is what it is giving the meaning, right? So let's have this value. You will understand this importance of this line in few minutes now. Let me publish this, because whenever you want to run something, right, you need to publish, then only you can run something in the ADF data factory. So I am publishing it. Okay, publish got successful. Now click this dismiss. Now what I want to do is for this delete pipeline. Okay, so let me run this manually. Click this trigger now button, and once it loads, we need to click this OK button. So let's click that. So what it will do, it will start the execution of this pipeline manually. So pipeline execution is started. Let's go to monitoring. Once you go monitor, you can monitor all your pipeline executions there. As we discussed, you can see, okay, delete pipeline status is executed. Within 4 seconds it executed successfully. Open this pipeline and run delete pipeline so that I can check the activity level runs. So I have only one activity, that is delete activity, so it will appear here. You can see delete activity. Okay, see, delete activity and operation was successful in 2 seconds. And you can see there is something called user properties, right? Okay, see, when I click this here, see here it is seeing files deleted and it is giving the same value whatever I added. Let me add this value as a column. Click this plus sign, close this. Okay, let me refresh the execution. Okay, now let's scroll down here. See here, files deleted, that particular property came as a column here. And now see here, all text files in output folder of ADF demo container deleted. So by seeing this value, it will make sense for me, right? Okay, so this activity deleted all the files of ADF demo container output folder. So this is for the user better understanding when you monitor something inside them, pipeline runs or activity runs. So that's how the user properties will helpful. Okay, so now see, this is successful. Click this output button which will give the JSON and it will say how many files deleted. See, totally 2 files deleted, because we have only two text files here, right? See, 2 text files. If I refresh here, it will be empty now because it deleted, right? So now it will be empty. See, refresh completed, there are no files now because this delete operation deleted them, right? So in this way you can delete. So one more thing, we have enabled logging, right, for this. So we have enabled logging and we have given the path like ADF demo container, right? So let's go to container. You can see the new folder created here, something called with a strange string right here, string number. We'll open this. Okay, so see, this is the log file actually. So this file will contain all the files and folder, I mean whatever the operations performed, right? It will be there. Okay, let me click this view or edit, or let me do one thing. Let me download the file and show you. So let me open ADF demo container. Let me open this path where the log file created for the delete activity. Okay, now let me select this, click on this download button. Okay, file got downloaded. Let's open this CSV file and see. It should have listed all both the two files, abcd.txt and data.txt. See here, this is the txt file, category is file, status is deleted. This is another file, category is file, status is deleted. There is no error. So you can see in this way, it will log the information of the files which you deleted. Okay, so that's in this way, logging will help you. So let's go back to our pipeline and show you where the logging is once again. Okay, so for this delete activity, logging settings. So here we have defined it. So that's the reason that file got created, logging file. Okay, so let's go to presentation. So, okay, whenever you are watching this video, I will recommend to open this link. So what this link will contain is whatever the supported data stores and our file systems currently for this particular activity. So at this moment, all these data stores and the file systems are supported to perform the delete activity. Okay, but by the time when you are watching video, there might be new connectors also supported for this activity. There might be new storages also supported. So that is the reason it will be good if you open this link of Microsoft documentation and to get the idea what and all the supported data stores or file systems. Okay, so let me show you quickly there. I have already opened that. See here, supported data stores. Click on here. It will give you all the full list of the supported data stores. Okay, so hope I have covered everything. Let's go to presentation. So thank you, friends. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to get notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.